Hello, professionals. Good evening, everyone. And thank you so much for taking our time to join this self-registration review slash tutorial on the FIRS Tax Pro Max platform. This review is brought to you by 121 Professionals, and my name is Chidima Osigwe. You can reach out to us via our email address, 121professionals@gmail.com, or you can give us a call on 081-830-31968. So it's going to be a very eventful one tonight. So let's get right into this. So we got an update from FIRS that taxpayers can now register for tax purposes on the FIRS website, right? And we also received a circular that's been publicized about the guidelines, step-by-step tutorial procedure on how to carry out the self-registration on the FIRS Tax Pro Max platform. So what we are going to be doing basically tonight is to check if the platform is working, if we can actually register, if we can do the self-registration from the comfort of our homes. I remember when I wanted to register 121 professionals on the Tax Pro Max platform, I was wondering, like, why can't I register? I kept on clicking on register and it wasn't working. And then, few months down the line, they've sent us an update that now we can register. So, I'm not registering 121 professionals, that has been registered already months ago, but I'll be making use of a company that I registered recently to test. But before we do the test, let's look at the circular that's been in circulation. Let's look at the step-by-step process and then we practicalize it to see if it is working. All right, so let's get right into this. Once again, my name is Chidima Osigwe. Okay, so let's look at the user manual for self-registration for a taxpayer. So it says below are different scenarios for self-registration. Entities with incorporation dates after 1st September 2023 can make use of the self-registration. So if you registered your business and it was incorporated last year, 2023, after September 1st, 2023, you can make use of the self-registration icon on the FIRS Tax Pro Max platform. So it says entities with incorporation dates before 1st of September 2023 cannot make use of the self-registration. You would need to visit your tax office. Wow, interesting. Apparently, this collaboration is with CAC and they're pulling out information from there to the FIRS platform. I think this update was done recently. So it's only fair that they make use of recent information instead of having to deal with backlog. In Nigeria, we know what happens to data, but we thank God for this collaboration. But something to note, I remember when I was registering 121 professionals on the Tax Pro Max platform, what I did was I filled the update form and I emailed it to the tax office, and I give it to Ikeja MSTO. They responded on time, and in 24 hours, I was set up on the Tax Pro Max platform. So I did not need to physically go to their office. I sent them an email. So I don't know about your tax office, and I don't know if they are proactive and how soon will respond to your email. So I just said that as an aside, right? Okay, so let's proceed. So we're going with entity one, right? Entities with incorporation date after 1st of September 2023. Luckily for us, we're going to be making use of a company that was incorporated in March 2024. So let's proceed. They said we're going to have this interface once we log on to the Tax Pro Max website. And then click on register. Then we click on Corporate Affairs Commission, and this is what we would have. The next page would be to input our CAC number and select the business type. If it's a limited liability company, it's an enterprise trustee, limited partnership, limited liability partnership, just click the business type. And the next interface would be this, where we can input our phone number or our email address or the channel we want them to send our one-time password through. It should be the registered phone number for the business, that number you use when you're filling your details on CAC, and also your email address, most likely you're filling in your details on CAC. So ensure that you don't make any mistake while completing your registration on the Corporate Affairs Commission platform. If you want to register your new business, 121 Professional is your surest plug. We are a phone call away, an email address away, a DM away, a WhatsApp message away. So a one-time password will be received. You type it and click on validate, and then we'll have this interface where it brings out all the taxpayer information, and we need to complete the declaration and click on submit. So does this work? There is only one way to find out. So let's get right into this. So if you are not sure of what the FIRS Tax Pro Max platform is, just type Tax Pro Max on Google, and then it brings out this. So you can click on Tax Pro Max, click on register. But let's click on Tax Pro Max, since on their documents they click on Tax Pro Max. I think register will still give us the interface, but let's have the exact interface as displayed. So wow, voila, we have this. So we have login, register, validate CCC, and non-residence registration request. So let's click on register. Let's click on Corporate Affairs Commission. Says we should fill in these details. So let me look for the details. So because it's a private limited liability company, I'll click on limited and click on search. It's loading. Nigeria, something went wrong. Please refresh this page. Okay, let's refresh the page and see what happens. So this company is a private limited liability company. So I'll just leave it on limited and then search. Wow, it brought out my details. Okay. So let me search for my phone number. Let me search for my phone number. Let me see if my phone number will pop up. There is no other phone number I used when doing the re Okay, let me do the email. Really? So let me check my email for the OTP that has been sent, and let's hope that it works. I'm checking my email and I'm not seeing any OTP.
A few moments later. A few moments later. One eternity later.
Okay, so it says an OTP has been sent. I need to wait for an hour before trying again. So I believe that because we've been trying a couple of times and we've been waiting for the OTP to be sent, once we receive an OTP, we'll just come back to continue registration, I guess. Let me do that. Oh, okay. So let's trust that they send the OTP. Okay, so we've been waiting, right? We've been waiting. So let's trust that they would send the OTP. And if they don't send the OTP as well, I would make a video to inform us, right? So once I receive the OTP, I'll come back to complete this video. About if it works or not, and if they do not send an OTP, I would also come back to complete this video about if it works or not. Thank you so much for taking out your time to join this quick review / tutorial class. This is brought to you by 121 Professionals, and you can contact us at 121professionals@gmail.com. Give us a call on 0818303-1968. My name remains Chidinma Osigwe. And thank you once again. You have a wonderful night. Bye.